Korean War was a conflict of the Cold War because it was a battle of communist, democratic, and capitalist ideologies between North and South Korea, which the US and USSR were involved. Right after World War II, General Order No. 1 set the Japanese to surrender to the US and USSR commanders in South and North Korea. On September 2, 1945, the US helped Syngman in every aspect to be the South Korean president. It was because Syngman was the biggest anti-communist in South Korea and balanced towards democracy and capitalism. September 8, 1945, the 38th parallel was established to divide the two Koreas. The US and USSR ideologies of communism, democracy, and capitalism were in conflict. The US military occupied the South, the USSR military occupied the North, the US was democratic and capitalist, the USSR was communist. Capitalism was a free market that allowed people to earn money freely and qualities of goods increased. Democracy allowed freedom, varieties of power, and choices to choose from. In a communist country, everybody worked the same, treated equally, and worked for benefits of everyone. The communist government was the only government in control of everything. A dictator represented the country, a dictator made the choices. Communism versus democracy and capitalism was called the proxy war. Americans helped countries wanting for democracy and capitalism, while the USSR did the same thing too. The Soviets aided Kim Il-sung to be the North Korean president in every way possible. The Soviets preferred him because he was a powerful politician and believed in communism. On December 1945, North Korea wanted to sign the Moscow Accords to transform into a communist country, but the US refused. May 10, 1948, UN proposed elections were held. Those who rejected the Moscow Accords were banned by the USSR, but the US gave South Koreans another chance. On July 24, 1948, Syngman Rhee became president of South Korea. On August 15, 1948, ROK was made. On August 28, 1948, Workers' Party of North Korea was founded. On September 9, 1948, Kim Il-sung became the leader of North Korea. The North Korean government brutally suppressed uprisings. Meanwhile, newly elected President Rhee's NSL effectively suppressed any uprisings against his government. After hearing news, China became communist on October 1, 1949, and the Soviets gaining knowledge of nuclear on January 15, 1950. Justin spoke to the president regarding about the issues of communism about needing action, however didn't mention about Korea. North Korea and USSR interpreted Acheson's speech as not caring about Korea. Asked the USSR to invade the South, persuading him with propaganda and allowed Kim to attack ROK on June 25, 1950. North Korea sent varieties of tanks, fighter planes, guns, cannons, and armor. Mostly derived from the USSR, 134,000 soldiers marched to the 38th parallel with light weapons and protection. The North Korean People's Army arrived in Seoul on June 28, 1950 and took over Seoul. On June 27, 1950, the US summoned an emergency meeting at the UN Security Council. The USSR didn't attend because they were in a heated argument earlier. The UN agreed on Truman's decision to help Korea for communism, for it may become widespread threat, thus General MacArthur was appointed general. The Han Bridge, but the NKP overcame and marched to victory, then tortured South Korean civilians. On June 28, 1950, Seoul was captured, came in action on July 1, 1950, providing 540 men and weak weaponry, resulting to defeat. On July to August 3, the UN troops and US Air Forces occupied Busan perimeter. The NKPA came to the Busan perimeter in hopes of unifying Korea under Kim Il-sung. 140,000 U.S. soldiers with powerful weapons and sufficient supplies fought off the NKPA for 6 weeks. The U.S. Air Force were too good for the enemies to handle. The NKPA weren't organized and fully prepared enough to win the Busan perimeter and retreated. On September 15, 1950 was Operation Crowbat, MacArthur's surprise attack to surround the NKP in Incheon worked. 75,000 UN troops and 13,000 US Marines took care of business in Incheon. Militarily, the NKP lost a great amount, while ROK, UN, US forces suffered very little in casualties, infrastructures, and wounded. The NKP were pushed back to the 38th parallel. ROK, UN, and US troops fought hard on crossing the 38th parallel to an easy victory. So on October 15, 1950, the general and president met in Hawaii. The general promised him China wouldn't intervene, USSR military aid was running low, then discussed the benefits of rolling back communism, unifying Korea under democracy and UN recognition. On October 19, 1950, Pyongyang lost. On November 24, 1950, NKPA were driven back to the Yalu River. Mao feared US would roll back communism in China and sent 600,000 soldiers to the north. On April 11, 1951, MacArthur was relieved for not obeying. For peace, the operation started. Syngman Rhee treated North Korean civilians harshly. Negotiations, Operation Little Switch and Operation Big Switch were used. Sick and wounded soldiers were traded and soldiers had individual rights. On July 27, 1951, Korea signed an armistice at Panmunjom.